Hi, in this video, we'll explore different fruit tree guilds that are suitable for temperate climates, each centered around separate apple, plum, pear, and cherry fruit trees. As we discussed in the previous video, fruit tree guilds are an essential component of a healthy and sustainable food forest. By selecting plants that complement each other's functions and roles, we can create a self-sustaining and regenerative ecosystem that mimics the patterns and processes found in nature. So let's get started with the apple tree guild first. For the overstory tree layer, we've chosen a nitrogen-fixing honey locust. In the shrub layer, we have a nitrogen-fixing gummy berry. At the base of the apple tree, we have comfrey, which mines nutrients from deep in the soil and makes them available to the apple tree. In a ground cover layer, we have strawberries. Red clover is planted everywhere on the open field to minimize the chances of wild grasses robbing nutrients from apple trees. To protect the trees from cold summer wind, we positioned an edible windbreak consisting of hazelnut and walnut trees. Moving on to the Plantry Guild, it is surrounded by nitrogen-fixing black locust. The guild includes plants that are more tolerant of wet soil, such as currants. They provide a diverse range of fruits and they also attract pollinators. Other plants that are commonly used in a plum tree guild include wildflowers and herbs such as lupin, lemon balm, poppies, daisies, and mint and oregano to repel pests and attract beneficial insects. To protect plum trees from cold winter wind, we've planted evergreen windbreak consisting of pine, cedars, and juniper. Next up is the Pear Tree Guild. This guild includes a pear tree as the centerpiece with nitrogen-fixing black alder in the overstory. Wisteria in a shrub layer will further improve soil health as it is also fixing nitrogen from the air. Gooseberry will attract pollinators and provide additional source of food, whilst borage will guard the pear from pests and diseases. Peanuts as a ground cover will not only fix nitrogen, but will also suppress weeds and control erosion. Alliums, on the other hand, will repel fruit tree borers. Finally, the cherry tree guild. Cherry is surrounded by red alder, a nitrogen-fixing tree that can help improve soil fertility in the cherry guild. Its roots also help to stabilize the soil and prevent erosion. We have also raspberries because they help to shade the soil, reduce weed growth, and provide an additional source of food. A mix of wildflowers such as chamomile, calendula, and wild violet can help to attract pollinators. This can help to increase fruit production and control pests naturally. Finally, in the root layer, we've got horseradish, which can help to loosen and aerate the soil. It also repels pests such as aphids and flea beetles. In between rows of fruit trees, we have a silvopasture. Silvopasture is a land management system that combines trees, livestock, and forage crops to create a sustainable and productive ecosystem. In a silvopasture system, trees are intentionally planted or retained to provide shade, shelter, and food for livestock, while also contributing to soil health and ecological diversity. The forage crops in silvopasture system are typically a mix of grasses, legumes, and other plants that are well suited to the local climate and soil conditions. These crops provide food for the livestock while also improving soil fertility and preventing erosion. Examples include ryegrass, alfalfa, red clover, and dogwood. And there you have it. Four different fruit tree guilds in temperate climate, each incorporating various food forest layers. These are just a few examples of the many different fruit tree guilds that can be designed in temperate climate. The key is to select plants that provide a range of functions and benefits that support the health and productivity of the fruit tree while also benefiting the overall ecosystem. Thank you for watching. Let me know which fruit tree guild presented here you like the most and why. In the next video, we'll discuss examples of fruit tree guilds in the Mediterranean climate. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you got value out of this video.